work in finance. God bless, no, this not by chance. Don't dab me, you're not my man. Don't at me, you're not my man. Mama said don't buy it if you cannot buy it twice. Buy it twice. I cop out of tools and I don't pump fake with the price. Always on the grind, I put in work with all my might. I know that he got me now by sight. That's for sure though. Grinding from the grip, no shame. Take a photo. Time to take a trip. We head north to the border. Say you filling up. I'm my favorite type of hoarder. I got kids to feed. I got enemies. I got God's gift, so they envy me. Got some friends out of Memphis like I'm Aubrey. Got some friends fought for orange like some autumn leaves.
I vanish, I slide out land dish, V12 engine, all black like Batman. All black like Batman. All black like Batman. All black like Batman. All black like Batman.
What's going on, guys? How you guys doing tonight? Zeke, Documentary TV, doing something just a little different. I'm going to do what, in honor of one of my good friends, one of my good YouTube friends, I'm going to do a somewhat of a reaction / video analysis video for you guys tonight. I came across this cool little video on YouTube, and I'm going to show it to you guys. I'm going to do a little video analysis, and it's because one of the bigger subjects that come up on this channel is protection training and how important is the protection training and how much of it is natural and all that other stuff. I found this video to be very interesting for a lot of reasons, so I thought I could give a little bit of, not insight, but analysis, my personal thoughts. Again, I'm not a protection dog expert, nothing like that, but I do spend a lot of time with and have a lot of conversations with people who are experts, and I've done quite a few videos on the subject. So I thought it'd be cool to do this video for you guys. So this is going to be a real quick video, but let me get set up real quick. This is the video right here. It's a dog named Dubai. I believe he's there in Utah. As you look in the video, you'll see that there's a gentleman who's just entered the house. And then how it plays out from there is very interesting. So I'm going to go ahead and play this video for you guys. Take a look at it. I'm going to stop it when I want to say something. There's no audio. This is just the surveillance footage of the incident. So you guys take a look. Let me set it up real quick right now. This guy here appears to be a vagrant, a homeless person with not much to lose in life, he looks like. And he just walked into this very nice home. All right, so let me go ahead and play this video real quick. All right, as you can see right there, he's greeted by a dog, which appears, I'm pretty sure it's a Great Dane. An older Great Dane, I would say the dog has to be 10 plus years old. He greets the man at the door. So obviously on some level, the dog is socialized. He's not as wary of the person as that I would hope that he would be, but you know, that could just be a product of socialization and the fact that he's home. So maybe, you know, at this point in his life, he's expecting that everybody and anybody that's in the house is cool. You know, he's not tremendously excited to see the person, but he's not threatening in any kind of way. So that's that. The man, you know, being a smart dude, is loving up on the dog. He's giving the dog a lot of love and attention. I guess he's trying to ingratiate himself with the dog with the hopes that he'll be able to do whatever he wants to do in the house. Dog won't bother him. Just some little backstory. I'm gonna pause it real quick right now. What's going on in the house right now? There's a woman. She has two sons, but only one son. She had made this in another video in a newscast. She had said that she had thought that the person entering the house was her older son. It wasn't. She has a younger son who was blind, who was actually in the house, but wasn't aware of who had actually walked in the house. And then she's in the house herself. So, again, the dog has greeted the interloper at the door and kind of just chilling with him at the moment. And like I said, the interloper is pretty much trying to be cool with the dog. And now they're going to move. He's going to move himself into the house. The dog is still pretty much looking at him. I think at this point right now, the dog, the owner, the woman who owns the house, has noticed that the man is in the house. And I believe she reacts. And then you can see immediately the dog comes back. Her energy has basically transformed the dog into somewhat of a protection animal. The dog, again, like you can tell that this dog hasn't had any protection training because of the way the dog is in his attack. You know, protection dogs that have been protection trained tend to be very focused in their when they're attacking a person. So I'm assuming this dog has had no protection training. Right at this point in time, the dog is probably operating off of genetics and the energy that he's getting from his owner. So there he goes. You know, basically the dog now is barking, riled up, has chased the guy out of the house, and the woman has jumped on the phone to call the police. All right, so that's the end of that. It's another video about to pop on after that. But what I wanted to say about that is that, you know, a lot of people say that, say that there's no genetic programming for protection, or that, you know, on some level that you need to seriously protection train your dogs in order to get any kind of protection out of them. And that's not something that I personally believe. I believe that all dogs, not all dogs, but, you know, definitely a master breed like a Great Dane, Rottweilers, Connie Corsos, Presses, German Shepherds, all these dogs have a certain level of protection instincts. And obviously this dog here was very inefficient, I guess, efficient in ridding the dude from the property. Now, obviously, you know, a dog that was protection trained would have probably, once the owner had given the command, executed a bite, and maybe even been able to apprehend the gentleman. This dog, who I'm assuming and I'm almost certain doesn't have any protection training, basically worked off of instincts. His mother, his owner, was frightened. She was afraid. He identified what she was afraid of, and he genetically or instinctually addressed the issue. Like I said, if you look at the way he addressed the issue, it wasn't the most effective, but it was effective because at the end of the day, the dude was frightened, and the dude left the house. Let me go back to that video real quick for you guys. Like, as you see, like, you know, at this point, the dog, this is before the woman recognized it. But we'll look at the whole sequence once the woman sees it. You'll see the dog, boom. Like, a protection dog is even going to jump on the arm, jump on the leg. This dog is kind of all over the place, biting at his butt. He's going to eventually lunge up at his face. But, you know, again, in terms of protection work, I mean, I give this dog an A+. He basically saved his owner, saved her property. And that's really all you can ask for from a protection dog. Now, the reality of it is that this dude was somewhat of a professional, or he was more intentional in his attack or his invasion of the home, the dog wouldn't have stood a chance. But I would also argue that in most cases, 99% of most cases, if someone's breaking into your house aware that you have a dog and it's very intentional on doing you and your dog harm, you know, I don't know how great a dog is going to be. I mean, you're going to probably need a dog and some sort of firepower to protect yourself. But that's that, guys. I mean, this is a great video. It's, if you just search for Great Dane Protects Its Owner, I believe you'll find there's several videos up. I believe Inside Edition has a video. There's a newscast about this video. I think you guys, you would love to see the backstory. I think it's a great little video to check out. But yeah, if you guys have any questions on, I'm going to take, you know, 5 or 10 questions on protection training. Yeah, Becky, who's that? Let's see. I'm going to take some questions. If you guys have some questions you want to ask me or you want to talk about, let's go ahead and talk about it real quick. This is going to be a short video, so I'm not going to go too far into it. Nicholas says the Danes have been bred to be timid. Their epigenetics have been altered, but they still have the master genes. I mean, I can probably, I don't know exactly specifically what you're talking about, Nicholas, but in regards to a lot of the dog breeds are now bred for the show rings, yes, their genetics have been altered. They have been softened to make these dogs much more social, basically, and probably much more suitable for the world that we live in today. I think that this dog right here is, you know, is a great example of, you know, a protection animal, just based on the fact, you know, a general protection animal. This is not a sporting animal. This is not a professional protection dog, but a dog that basically is big, large, is intimidating, is a visual deterrent, which is kind of my biggest thing for most protection dogs. You want the dog to be visually imposing and somewhat slow down any kind of aggressive behavior by any person. But if you believe that at the end of the day that a dog is going to be able to stop a very intentional person, I don't know that that's going to happen. You know, people, we have weapons, we have superior intellect over animals. So it'd be hard for a dog, if someone's really coming, like if you live in a life where somebody wants you hurt, harmed in some kind of way, you know, one dog is probably not going to do it. Two, three dogs may stand a better chance, but you know, those are choices that you have to make. I personally believe that a good protection dog is a dog that alerts, a dog that stands its ground. And I think in this case, a dog that was really willing to take the offensive and push the man out of the house. So this dog, his name is Dubai. He's a Great Dane, a senior Great Dane. I think he did a great job. You guys have any questions for me? Let me see if I can... The O-line Corsos are great dogs. I think that they, you know, they were, you know, I would think they would be more offensive than this dog. I'm talking, replying to Basic Rider. Yeah, I think they'll be great dogs. What's up, Mary Shine? How you doing? Cool stuff, Basic Rider. Cool stuff. Minister of Church, what's up, my brother? How's it going? Zoe, I have done some flock guardian breeds. I have Central Asian Shepherd videos. I have a Gomper video, Great Pyrenees, Kangal videos. What else do I have? I've done a lot of livestock guardian breeds. Spanish Mastiffs, Pyrenean Mastiff videos, tons of videos. Just kind of, if you want to search a breed, if you guys ever want to figure out what I've done a video on and what I haven't done, and I haven't done all the dog breeds by far, but if you guys are interested in figuring out what videos I have done, do me a favor, just search the dog breed name and then put in Dogumentary TV. So it's like German Shepherd, comma, Dogumentary TV, and I'm almost certain any video that I've done on that breed will pop up. American Gompers, comma, Dogumentary TV. I think you'll find my Gomper video. I did the Central Asian Shepherd, Tibetan Mastiff. So we got a lot of livestock, flock guardian dog breeds out there. Bill Jones, I mean, personally, I feel like a Great Pyrenees is a great, I never really seen them do any, I've never seen anyone do personal protection with Great Pyrenees. But I think genetically and instinctually, based on them being protective, being guardian breed, and understanding, you know, if they have a relationship with their owner, I think they would definitely stand between their owner and a possible threat. Now, the reality of it is, when you talk about possible threat, one of the things that all dogs have to have is they have to have some level of confidence in themselves and be willing to stand their grounds. So, I mean, that's something that I would test for if it's just something that you're interested in. I don't think you necessarily have to have a dog that's willing to attack somebody. But if you have a dog that's willing to stand its ground, a dog the size of a Great Pyrenees is going to pretty much deter 99% of most attackers to just leave you alone, to leave your property alone, to leave your person alone. Thank you, Nicholas. I appreciate you. Emerald Miss, you know I love the Rottweiler. AJ Morningstar, can the Siberian Husky be a good guard dog? I haven't heard much about that. I don't necessarily know that they would be. I would say if you're looking for a good guard dog, I wouldn't start with a Siberian Husky. Soren, yeah, I would love to do something Greyhound related. I mean, that would be ideal to get something done sooner than later. Right now, I'm trying to press. I've been putting out a lot of emails, sending out a lot of emails and a lot of inquiries with a lot of different breeds from Greater Swiss Mountain Dogs, Samoyed. I definitely would love to do a Greyhound video, a Bison Hound video. There's a lot of videos a lot of breeds that need to get covered. Obviously, you know, the COVID thing really kind of messed this year up for me, but we're going to work on that. We're going to work on all these breeds. Zoe, honestly waiting for a documentary on Berger Mascals and Overwatch, really. I'm not even familiar with either one of those breeds. What should you do? If you can find me on Instagram, I'm on Documentary TV. Just DM me some information on those breeds and I'll look into it. I don't know much about them. Bouviers, I think, I'm talking to Alex right now. Yeah, I believe that they can be good guard dogs. I don't know who's breeding them for to be good guard dogs at this time. I know that they do have some. They do, and I believe in France, they are some form of police dog or do some form of police work. I'm not going to say France. Just say somewhere in Europe. I'm not exactly certain where. Yeah, otter hound is something that I would love to get a hold of. But, you know, a lot of times, like I said, with the COVID thing, I'm not doing a lot of traveling. I mean, a lot of traveling just not happen. I'm kind of in a holding pattern. I'm trying to get as much done as I can get done within, you know, 200 miles of California. So California, Nevada, Arizona is really my working area right now. Maybe Utah. We'll see. Emerald Mist, does your Rottweiler have guardian instincts? My Rottweiler definitely has guardian instincts. He hasn't even been on any level. There's been no protection training whatsoever. I took him out a couple of weeks ago to a protection training session and just gonna let him watch, just really just see how he would behave and how he would react to all that energy from all the other dogs. In that environment, he did great, but he didn't take any bites. I'm not sure that I'm going to have him take any bites. That's not really my thing per se. But I will say that in terms of his genetics, he protects the house. Just protects the house. Just recently, which is kind of funny and kind of cool, but not necessarily cool. My sister came to stay with me. He had never seen her before. And she just showed up in the backyard. He barked at her. He didn't attack her, but he did bark at her. He did stand his ground. I was not too far away, so I was quick to tell him, no, she's cool. And honestly, he barked at her for probably, you know, the first day he was here. If she just popped up in the room by herself, he would bark at her. It's just what he did. And he would stand his ground. But she's been here for 2 days now. He kind of identified that, oh, she's going to be here. She's with him. She's with them. And he's now squeezing in next to her, next to the sofa, trying to get some love, trying to get some pets, trying to get some affection from her. So, yeah, I mean, he definitely has natural guarding instincts. You know, I have guys next door to him, either side of me. If they're ever doing anything in their backyard at weird hours, he's quick to bark at them. So he's very protective of the house, and not so much protective when he's outside of the house. I mean, I've taken him on walks and You know, if I introduce myself to somebody and we're having a conversation, people love to talk about him. He's a beautiful dog. And they always went, oh, what kind of, you know, where'd you get this dog from? He's so beautiful. I'm always having conversations on the street with people about him. And he's not the least bit aggressive. But he's been socialized into understanding that when we go on walks, we will run into strange people. And we will, from time to time, have conversations with him. All right, guys, I'm looking, you guys pretty much have run out of questions for me. I'm about to jump off. I just wanted to show that video with you guys, share that video with you. If you guys want, again, follow me on Instagram, just basically Dogumentary TV on Instagram. If you guys want to, if you guys have any ideas for shows, I'm going to start going live more often. So if you guys have any ideas for shows, for live shows, send me something on Instagram. Just, you can send me a message on Instagram. I'm going to be working on dog breeds. If you guys have any leads on a dog breed that you haven't seen the video, but you know, oh, there's a breeder in California, or there's someone with the dog in, you know, Arizona, Nevada, send me that information to just basically follow me on Instagram. And I will, Chinese Crescent, I don't think so. It'll happen one day. I won't be excited about it. It will just be probably a product of the fact that I've done every other breed in the world, and I actually have a plan. I'm going to do Chinese Crescent at some point. Actually, I knew a woman who had them, and I need to circle back with her. I'm going to do some more raw food. I mean, I don't know what else to do with the raw food videos. I don't necessarily change up his diet every day. There are little subtle changes to what he eats. So if you guys have any questions about, like I said, if you got some show ideas or whatever, and you want to talk about raw food, send them to my Instagram, or you can send them to me on Facebook. I also have a Dogumentary page on Facebook, Dogumentary Twitter, Dogumentary Instagram. It's all the same. It's all right there on the screen. What else do I want to say? Oh yeah, about the raw food. Oh no, I'm sorry. Canis Panther video. I was jacked a few years ago to do a Canis Panther video. I kind of did something. There's a woman up in Central Valley, California, and she breeds a version of the Canis Panther, which is okay, but obviously there's probably other people who you guys would rather see with Canis Panther videos. I will try to find them. They're not in California, so I don't know that that's going to happen anytime soon. All right, guys. Well, that's pretty much it. I just wanted to do a quick little video. I'm going to try to put some videos up between now and this weekend. And that's pretty much it, guys. So to wrap this up, though, if you guys got information on a breeder that you guys want me to feature, find me on Instagram, Facebook, or Twitter. Send me a direct message, and I'll check it out. If you guys have a breed that you want me to feature, just a breed, you have information on it, I'll check it out. If it's not in California, if it's not within 200 miles of Southern California, the likelihood of me getting it done anytime soon ain't good, because, you know, obviously I'm not traveling too far. I have a wife and small children. I need to stay as healthy as possible, stay as productive as possible. So that's pretty much it. I want to thank you guys for taking time to do this. I will figure out a way to do more live videos. I'm actually also trying to do live interviews. So that's another thing. If you guys have people who you think I should interview, feel free to have them. Let me do this real quick. Feel free to have them contact me, email me, or find me on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter. And then I will try to set up a live stream interview. Maybe we just do a live stream interview and get that information out there to you guys. All right. I'll talk to you guys on the next one. All right, man. Peace.
Funhouse active. King of the palace. Rubber like Malcolm. Ball the fist in the air to the fast lit. Yeah. And
hands up in the air, that they gun me down. I keep it 100, they crunching the numbers, I'm young out. Young hitter, got a fetish for success. If I ain't next, then I just leave him pressure. Next to rain on the window pane, puffin' plain Jane. Let him second guess me, wanna cop the Porsche with the Porsche skin. Rip the wheels, let the horses just spin. Why they trash, that's a chore on my list. Added a sword, but I saw with the pen. I'm eating good, Miss Caloric is lit. I sipped the potion and poured it in. I on the tie, watch me pour it in. Opportunity knock at the door, then I grin. They rush for the doors, and it open like biscuit. Pin stroke, game code is the fridge. Sound wave for like more than the clicks. Cowboy bug, I surf the web for the hits. Ayy. Been gritty, don't pity, they full thing with me, been real. I'm trended, I'm hype, I'm litty, been this since scrimmage, don't play game with me. I volley these hits like I play tennis, I grip this shit, now I live it, don't pity. I live pill at the top through the city, now I run this. I would jot it with the pencil while they flop, with the vision jaw drop when I spit it off top, little. Hitty, these seven figures catch the fade when it jit me. Battle count it down to the penny wave. Heavy is all on my mind, I've gotta make that edit. Wait, but I might spark that wildfire, rebel when I breach. Funhouse active, yeah, king of the palace. Rubber like Malcolm, ball the fist in the air to the flashlight. Yeah, hands up in the air that they got me down. I keep it on it, they crunching the numbers, I'm being wild. Funhouse active, yeah, king of the palace. Rubber like Malcolm, ball the fist in the air to the flashlight. Yeah, hands up in the air that they got me down.